In this video, we will implement Cuckoo search algorithm using Python. So what is Cuckoo search algorithm, how it works, its mathematical models using numerical example. We already discussed in previous videos. So right now in this video, first we will discuss the key points of Cuckoo search algorithm and then its pseudocode, and then step by step we will implement this algorithm using Python. So first you can see here how this algorithm works. So first you will define the objective function. Here you can define any objective function you're working on. Then initialize the important parameters. After that, initialize the population, evaluate the population using objective function, and then we'll apply a Lewis flight to calculate new position. And after that, we will compare the new solution with the older one and then rank them and replace. After that, check the stopping criteria. If it is met, then stop and display the best solution, else we will repeat this loop. So here you can see the pseudocode for this algorithm. So Cuckoo search algorithm inspiration, as we know, that is inspired by the behavior of cuckoo bird. So cuckoo bird lay their egg in the nest of other birds that increase their offspring chances of survival. So when the cuckoo bird is laying their eggs in the nest of other species birds, so there is a possibility that their eggs are discovered by other birds. So here we will denote other bird with the host word. Okay, so if the host word discover the cuckoo egg, either it throw it out or abandon the nest and build new one. So first we will generate the n host nest. So in this algorithm we have nest and eggs. The potential solution to the population represented as the nest and individual solution within nest are like eggs. And this algorithm also follows certain rules, like that cuckoo can lay only one egg at a time in a randomly chosen nest. So here, get a cuckoo randomly and then replace its solution by performing Lewis flight, evaluates its fitness, then we'll choose a nest among n randomly, then it's compare the fitness value, replace the solution. After that, we will check the fraction PA, that is the fraction of the worst nest is abandoned and the new one is created. We'll keep the best solution and replace the weaker one. Then we'll rank the solution and find the current best. Pass the solution to the next iteration. Repeat the loop until stopping condition is met. And once it is met, we'll stop and display the best solution. Now step by step, we will implement this algorithm using Python. So first we will import all the important libraries. So here we are using NumPy as NP. Then from math, we import gamma. In the Lewis flight calculation, the gamma value is used, that is used from the library. Key steps from this code: define your objective function, initialize the population, calculate Lewis flight, and then we'll apply the cuckoo search algorithm. First we will define an objective function. Here you can define any objective function you're working on. So right now we are using here the sphere function, and we want to minimize this function. Take one single argument, you can see x, and this function will calculate the fitness of a given solution vector x. So you can see this function is calculating the sum of square of all elements of x. Now we will create initial population of random solution, that is nest. So here we will initialize the population with specified population size and the dimension. This function take two parameters, that is population size and number of dimension in the solution space, and it will return here randomly distributed values, that is random solution vector within range -5 and 5. -5 is here lower bound, 5 that is the upper bound. Then we have the population size and then dimension. So we need all the solution within these bounds. that is upper bound and the lower bound. After that, we will calculate here the Lewis flight. For Lewis flight calculation, you can see here we are using this equation. So simply we will write this equation. And so inside this function, you can see we have one parameter, that's beta. We will calculate sigma using this equation, and then value for u, that is normally distributed between 0 and 1, and then v value 0 and sigma, then value for v, that is also normally distributed from 0 to 1, between 0 and 1. And you can see we are taking the values for u and v from the NumPy library. After that, we'll calculate the step size using this equation. So write down this equation here. Then this function will return the step size that we will use in the cuckoo search algorithm for the movement of the cuckoo word. Now we will apply cuckoo search algorithm. We will define the function. In this function, we have parameters. First, we are using objective function that we already declared above. Population size, we have 50. Dimension, we are using 2. Maximum iteration, we have 100. PA value, that is the probability of abandoned nest, we have 0.25. After that, first we will initialize the population. So here, population function, so initialize population, this function we already declare above. So inside this we have two parameters, population size and dimension. So this will initialize the population. After that, we will calculate the fitness value for each solution in the population using objective function. So we are using here NumPy array to convert the list of fitness value. Objective function nest for each nest in the population. This will calculate the fitness by passing the solution to the objective function, and then it will iterate over each solution in the population and then calculate the fitness value for each solution in the current population and store them. After that, we need the variable to save the best solution. So here we will set the variable for tracking best solution found. Right now it's none. Then we have another variable, that is best fitness, that is used to track the best fitness value. So this variable is initialized to infinity. So this is not infinity. We will write it here. We'll write it as np.infinity, that is positive infinity. So here this value is initialized to the positive infinity. Now the main loop for cuckoo search algorithm started here. So this loop will iterate for maximum number of iteration until stopping condition is met. So in each iteration, we will generate new solution, that is cuckoo, using Lewis flight. So right now we have no new solution generated. So first we will create an empty array to store the newly generated solution. Now for each solution in current population, we will calculate step size. So here we'll calculate the step size for the movement. So here we are using the Python inbuilt function that will iterate over all elements of population array. For the step size calculation, we are using the Lewis flight function that we already declare above, and the value for beta we are using here 1.5. Next, we will generate step direction. Done, step size is calculated. Now we need the step direction. So step direction is generated randomly. So this is a random number that is uniformly distributed between minus 1 and 1. Now we will create a new nest, that is a new solution, by adding step size and direction to the original solution, that is nest. And after that, this new solution generated, it is added to the new population. So here the new solution is generated using Lewis flight, and it is also added in the new population. Now we'll check the boundary. So we have the lower bound minus 5, upper bound 5. So we will check the solution is within the bounds or not. So here we will clip the new solution to ensure that it stay within specific bound minus 5 and 5 or not. So this is the boundary check. So now new solution is calculated, its boundary check is also done. Now we will calculate the new solution fitness. So here we will calculate the fitness of the new solution using objective function, and then we'll store the value into new fitness into this variable. So here again we are using this objective function. We have the sphere function, you can use here, you will use your own objective function. Now let's compare and replace old solution with new better solution. So as the new solutions are generated, now we will compare the older solution with the new solution. If new solutions are better, then we will replace them. So now we will create an array. So first we will check whether the new solution fitness is less than the older fitness or not. So it will replace only the new solution that have the better fitness value. So in the population, it will replace only the solution, only the new solution that have the better fitness value. And then we will update fitness array, because if in the population we found any better solution, we will update its position plus its fitness value. So here we will replace it. After that, based on the population fitness value, we will sort. Now we sort the population based on their fitness value. Population and the fitness array, they are sorted together in ascending order of fitness using np.arg sort. This is a NumPy function that will return the position of solution in the population array. So this will return the index of solution in the population array that is sorted based on their fitness value. So we have a variable sorted solution, and then using this function they will return a index with the sorted fitness value. So here we will update the fitness value. So here we will compare if the fitness value of best solution in the sorted population is better than the current best fitness, then the new best solution and its fitness values are updated. So here if the new solution fitness is better than the current best, then we will update it. So here we'll update the best solution position and its fitness value. After that, we will abandon the egg with the probability and using a probability value PA and then lay new eggs. So now we will abandon a portion of solution and generate new one. So first we will calculate the number of solution to be abandoned based on the probability value PA into its population size. Now we will select those abandoned egg from the population without any replacement. So here we are selecting the abandoned egg. So population sum from the population size we have abandoned egg and there is no replacement. So replace false. So now we will replace the abandoned solution with the new one generated. So we're using here this initial population. So we're using this function here for the replacement of the abandoned solution. And finally, we'll calculate the fitness value of the newly generated solutions. So here we'll initialize the population for the abandoned eggs in the new in dimension and the dimension. Then we will calculate the fitness value for the newly generated solution. We'll display the number of iteration. Loop is repeated. Then display fitness value in each iteration. And in the end, we will display the best fitness value and the position. So we'll call this function Google search. So inside this, we have objective function. So using this, it will calculate. So this subjective function will calculate the best solution and the best fitness. Then we'll print, then we'll display the best solution value and best fitness found so far. After that, we will run the code, and then we have a slight error. We have an error here. We have one error. So I have one bracket error. Again run. Now instead of array we have the simple bracket. Now run the code. Run the code. Now you can see we have a new error. So here inside this loop we will return the best fitness and the best solution. Again we'll run the code. Now you can see it is working. So now you can see, so every time we will get the different position and the different fitness value because of randomness. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.